I'll bring back Samuel Abuginapo's justification why a state of emergency cannot be declared. But I can now take you live to the TC headquarters where the meeting with organized labor has just ended.
Organized labor declared a nationwide strike. We referred from October 10th, 2024. This followed the failure of government to address our demands to halt illegal mining in and around river bodies and forest reserves, as outlined in our press statement on October 11, 2024. Subsequently, the President of the Republic, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, met with the leadership of organized labor on October 3rd, 2024. At that meeting, government offered a series of measures it intended to implement as part of efforts to combat the menace of illegal mining in the country. At a meeting of organized labor on October 7th, 2024, the meeting resolved that the measures announced by government were not adequate in addressing our demands and stopping the dangers posed by illegal mining. We therefore affirmed the strike notice and informed the government accordingly. Yesterday, October 8, 2024, the government team met with the leadership of organized labor and Ghana Employers Association. The meeting discussed at length organized labor's response to the earlier measures announced by government. Following this meeting, government offered enhanced and time-bound measures in respect of our demands and the fight against illegal mining. These measures include, one, the revocation of the environmental protection, that is the mining in forest reserves, Regulations 2022, LI 2642. His Excellency the President has directed the Minister responsible for lands and natural resources to submit a memorandum for the revocation of the LI to Parliament when it reconvenes on Tuesday, October 15, 2024. The redeployment of the military and other law enforcement agencies to flush out illegal miners from water bodies and forest reserves. The military is now supporting the forest guards of the Forestry Commission to protect the forest reserves from destruction by illegal miners and loggers. Government, working with the judiciary, has already established 14 dedicated courts, 7 high courts, and 7 circuit courts to handle illegal mining cases. Collaboration with the organized labor and other stakeholders to fight illegal mining, government has asked organized labor to nominate representatives to be part of the stakeholders committee to fight illegal mining in the country. 5, government supports the call by organized labor for all presidential candidates to sign a pact committing to the fight against illegal mining. 6, government affirmed its commitment to engage with stakeholders, including organized labor and the Ghana Employers Association, to bring an end to illegal mining in Ghana. These are significant concessions that organized labor demands has and threats have forced government to make towards combating illegal mining. That's Galamsey in Ghana. Comrades, organized labor has therefore decided to suspend the internal strike action. We are calling all workers to report for work on 10th of October 2024 and beyond. Organized labor will keenly monitor the implementation of these measures which government has made, and government will hear from us if it fails to do the needful.